extremely humid. United lost my duffel bag. So 2 out of 3 of my last flights have lost luggage. But it's okay, I have the bag tag number, so I'm gonna do it online later on. Just waiting on my Uber right now, and then I'm gonna head back to Sugar Land. You guys know my first stop has to be Alphalete. Papa Guzman's here.
The goat! What up? He's alive! Comes in with his suit.
What's up, bro? Where you been at?
Everywhere, man.
Are you what's up, Shark? At 10:12?
Yes, I am. Good to work out?
Yes,
sir. Cheers. I'm working out in this sweater today. I want to sweat. I haven't sweat or had a good workout in like 4 days. Got here.
All sweaty, man.
I know. I'm about to.
You good?
Yeah, I'm good.
Missed you, man. You sick or what?
A little bit.
Throat.
Huh?
A little bit on my throat.
We used to have 2 Stairmasters. Now we have 1, 2, 3, 4. And I picked up a 5th one for my house. So now I can do cardio at my house, late nights. Heck yeah. God damn.
Same clip. Curl the top. There you go.
You don't really appreciate Alphalete Gym. You don't have it for like 2 weeks. Charlie and I were just saying how. What were we saying, Charlie? How?
It's the best gym in the world.
It's the best gym in the freaking world.
Don't really appreciate it until you don't really know what you have until it's gone. It's really been gone for the last month. Feels good to be home.
Everything is here.
Feels fucking amazing.
Feels fucking amazing. Feels good. Feels real good. Love this gym. Love it. So excited to walk in this door right now. Oh my gosh. Home. One of my favorite things to do is to get my car washed right before I leave town. So when I come home, it feels fresh. I weighed myself at 185.6, I think, this morning on my vanity plan scale, which tells you the body fat. I think I was 14.7. So if you guys want to check out that scale, I have a discount for 60%, 60% off. The link is in my description box, so just check it out if you want, if you're interested. I want to weigh in like 181, 182, which I think I can do in just a few days of getting back on track. Cause I've literally like yesterday for lunch, I had a whole pizza at the airport. So today is the start of that. And there's a ton of work to catch up on. So let's go. Becca, what's up?
What's up?
We organizing.
Nice. I have these 2 things for you.
Somebody sent me a poster.
Look at that. I'm definitely, can we frame this?
We have
I already have a frame checked out.
Perfect. That's when you go to the new house.
We got like this Switch Monster and one scoop of Ghost in here. Nikki B's working out with Frank today. I'm gonna go hit some push workout. And my battery's almost dead, so I'm not gonna record too much. Becca's doing important stuff. Very important stuff. How's your workout? I'll show you guys how mine went.
How's that look, man?
God damn. I thought I was gonna pass.
She had a big package in.
From who?
Eric Garcia.
Eric Garcia.
At Universal Music
Group. At Universal Music Group. With a guitar signed by Dierks Bentley. A bunch of records. Like, look at all the CDs.
Dierks Bentley, Josh Turner, Sam Hunt, they're all with this.
Luke Bryan?
Yeah.
They're all signed with this company?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Huh.
I feel like you need another acoustic one.
Yeah, thank you. Thank
That's
you,
cool. That's gonna be going to the CMAs now, the Country Music Awards now.
Yeah, he said, if you ever need tickets to a show or M&G's, let me know.
What are the chances?
I actually really like Sam Hunt, and I like all these guys.
Yeah. That's crazy.
Human small town.
Okay, we're here at the house that I'm moving into September 30th. Gonna go see the progress on it. Here's Nick and Beth.
Look at
that. Oh, that looks nice. It is a good one.
Black and white. Here's the glass.
We had to go outside. Oh, you can just walk right up here. She has a dark
spot. The jacket's coming along nicely. Looking real nice. Cabinets, kitchen's coming along. Second floor view. Here's a view from the corner.
Okay, my camera died, and so now I'm using Nikki's. But this is the master bedroom, so there's actually a balcony on the second. As you can see.
Yeah.
And third floor. So here's the view above the trees. Master Beth.
Oh my gosh. It's just hard. There's a window in the closet. Windows.
For my house. How high are we? Damn. That's so cool.
Adventurers.
You could do something up here.
Oh, we can put your string lights up here. This will be so nice and like. We're thinking Christmas lighting already, guys. Just all Christmas, all the time.
We're keepers. Nikki's food wasn't good today. Beef teriyaki is too chewy and overcooked, but.
As for medium, to be fair, I probably should have said medium rare.
Medium rare, yeah. This weather is so bad. Shaw got a Mac.
Yo. So for this Mac, me and my mom, we were running errands all day, and like I took her out to lunch, bought her lunch, whatever, because I haven't seen her in a while because I've been traveling. And we got to Best Buy, she was like, she like made sure I needed to use the restroom. She was like, because we have to go somewhere else after this. I was like, okay. So I went to the restroom, and it was like she already had, well, she did have it planned. went to the restroom, came out of the restroom, and she like had this box, a MacBook Pro box. And I was like, what are you doing? You bought one for yourself? And she was like, no, it's for you, happy birthday. And like, I just like started immediately like tearing up, and like, I didn't cry because I'm a gangster, but I just got really emotional. And like, I told her thank you, but my mom surprised me, got a MacBook today.
Nice. I haven't even told anyone, but the house I showed you guys earlier, Joe's gonna be running out the bottom floor. So, yeah.
I'm gonna sublease it out somewhere.
Make a profit. I'm gonna tell him about the car right now, huh?
Not sure, dude.
I was just saying what I'm doing.
Better than your channel. Right?
You know what?
Dude, someone commented was like, I like your channel better than Christian's. And I was like, yup.
Tomorrow, I'm gonna go drive a 2017 R8 V10 Plus.
You know it's true. And all the things that come back to you. Say it with me, if it's just for today. Maybe tomorrow the good will take you away. Oh, dream on, dream on, dream on. Dream yourself a dream come true.
What's up, Nikki B?
Dream on.
Dream on. Oh, ow, that was bad.
We are fabulous singers, if I just say so myself.
Okay, so topic of conversation. As I was driving to Nikki's house, it was a 40-minute drive, and that's like a nice time to sort of collect thoughts and just enjoy that time yourself. And I just want to touch on the topic of kind of success, because a lot of you watching this video are 15, 16, you're in high school, graduating, going to college, getting your degrees, pursuing a career, you know, and you have goals. You want to be better in life. You want to succeed. You want to make a nice income. You want to help people. You want to change lives. And it's amazing, right? And all of us have that in common, that we're starting here, and you want to sort of build your own empire, right? You want to see success. And a lot of people think that success is this linear curve, but those first years when everything is really difficult, you don't see much progress, you know, your curve is like this, you're up and you're down and you're barely making any progress, and all of a sudden, you know, you continue working and working, and then that kind of comes up and comes up and comes up, and then, you know, years later you look back and you're doing well for yourself, you're happy, you have, you know, you're making money and everything seems like it's going well. And the point I was trying to make is, as that curve comes up and up and up, a lot of people are going to want to come in your life. It's going to seem like your friend, like, doors just open up, right? Everyone wants to come in, and this person wants to come in, and because you're doing so well, and it almost becomes hard to tell who's wanting to come into your life for the right reasons, and who, and some people may not be coming in for the right reasons. But the whole point of all of that is to never forget to acknowledge and appreciate those people that were there during this time frame, not this time frame. And, you know, it's okay to be open and meet new people and let people in, but like I said, just don't forget to be grateful for these people, because without those people, without those people's support, you may not be where you are today. And looking back for myself, I'm just very, very thankful for the people that have been with me, you know, before this massive gym, before the employees, before before a lot, you know, before all this sort of started happening. And those people will have your back no matter what, so just be sure that you remind yourself to have their back no matter what. Show them that same support, reciprocate it, and yeah, that's really it. Be thankful for what you got and what you have, but also what you had at the very beginning. And that's it. So, was that good?
Mm-hmm.
Is that better?
Mm-hmm.
It's like take number 50. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you next video.
Trust no hoes.